He's led his party and been a minister. Now he's going it alone.
Today, I'm announcing my intention to retire from Parliament.
Sure, he was rolled as leader in 2020, but it's a surprise move for the man who's number three and holds the coveted finance portfolio.
What's going on here? Why are you resigning?
Look, it's pretty simple. For me personally, it's time. I'm going to explore some commercial opportunities. And, you know, I've got a young family, and at 45, I feel like it's their time as well.
This is a decision that Simon's come to on his own accord.
It's a blow for the new national leader, who was basking in the glow of strong results in last week's One News Canter public poll.
How damaging is this for the National Party?
Oh, not at all.
Why rock the boat now when National are finally making some inroads?
I think the reality is there's never a perfect time, but when National's got wind in its sails, there's a better time.
As well as his dancing and musical skills.
Any sort of youth section of a Tory party is always going to be labelled as young rich boys.
He comes with 3 decades of experience in politics.
Hiya, guys.
Good morning.
Including 14 as an MP.
I think this leaves a big gap on National's front bench.
Look, I think we've got really great depth. I think when you just look at our performance over the last few months.
Now he's got a by-election to fight in Tauranga.
Particularly in Tauranga, which is a safe National seat, there's a lot of anger, I think, at the current government.
We're going on a walk together, the Yak and I.
He's a well-known local MP.
Quite shocked, actually.
Good on him, I think.
Fair enough.
It's a tough place in that beehive. It's full of stings and nasty stuff at times.
So this is his last hurrah in the debating chamber.
Will I always be his favourite National finance spokesperson?
I've been giving significant thought to this question, and I can confirm for the member that among the 6 National Party finance spokespeople I have faced, he's in the top half.
What will he miss most about me?
I look forward to his hosting of the Country Calendar Yak special.
As the National Party says, bye-bye, Mr. Bridges.
And Jess is joining us now from Parliament. Kia ora, Jess. How much of a loss is this for National?
This is really bad timing for the National Party. Yet again, it's talking about itself. It was on a roll, it had momentum, and this is definitely a distraction. There's also no guarantee that the National Party will hold on to that Tauranga seat. And early on in his leadership, Christopher Luxon is going to be facing a big test in this by-election. Now, Simon Bridges has been around the block a few times. He's been in this place for a long time. He's been through things like the Jamie Lee Ross scandal, and he really brings that political experience that Christopher Luxon lacks. The National leader needs people like him standing by him. It was also interesting to note that Simon Bridges came down to answer media questions by himself today. Christopher Luxon answered the questions separately, so there was no show of unity or harmony with the National Party today.
You just mentioned the importance of political experience. As we know, the finance role is critical. Who has National got that could step into it?
I understand the 2 names in the mix are Nicola Willis and Chris Bishop. Now, Nicola Willis is, of course, the 2 I see. At the moment, she has the gravitas to take on that finance spokesperson role. But Chris Bishop, who is currently the COVID-19 response spokesperson, he is going to be wrapping up his role a bit as the border starts to open. So that role will start to change, and he could be a good option for Christopher Luxon as well. But it won't officially be announced until tomorrow. And yet again, the National Party will be focusing on its own internal politics.
There's another gap he leaves, of course, in Tauranga. So let's talk by-election. Winston Peters held the seat for years. Could this be his comeback?
Now, in true Winston Peters style, he is refusing to confirm or deny whether he'll be contesting that Tauranga seat. He does like to keep people guessing. We know that. I understand that the party will be meeting at 7:30 tonight to discuss whether this is an option. So a lot of moving parts and a big day here at Parliament.
E Paramata at Parliament. Jessica Much-Mackay. Kia ora.